Well, joining us in studio now is Danielle Correa. She's going to talk about her work at Catholic Relief Services. And Danielle, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you for having
me. Hi, Danielle.
You know, I was thrilled to hear that a young lady from New Jersey originally is a Boston fan. Now, I know I say that with you know, places we're all over the country. So our friends in San Antonio or Louisiana or Philadelphia probably say, oh, well, we're not Boston fans. But you are, so that's
good to
know.
I'm going on national record here. Oh, no.
Did you grow up in this area?
I grew up in New Jersey.
Yeah, she's from New Jersey. Went to Boston College.
There's the connection.
That's where I fell in love with Boston.
There you go.
See? Well, tell us about your role at Catholic Relief Services. A great, great organization.
Thank you. Yes. My title is a regional relationship manager from CRS, and what that means is I build and sustain lasting relationships with Catholic dioceses and university partners and Catholic schools around the Northeast and Mid-Atlantic region. So I work with across five dioceses, and I work also with something like dozens of university and school partners. So just for example, Boston College is one that we partner with.
That makes sense.
Yep, and Assumption College likewise in New England. So it's a lot of fun. A couple of the dioceses, I'm also serve as the main liaison to the Archdiocese of Boston here, and Portland, Maine are just a couple of examples.
Now, when I think of CRS, Catholic Relief Services, my mind immediately conjures up a rice bowl. Mm-hmm. Operation Rice Bowl. And, you know, people make this connection between Lent and Advent. There is some connection. So I get the Rice Bowl thing in Lent, but what about right now? What about in the days leading up to Christmas? Yeah. What do we do?
That's a fantastic question. So we have many opportunities for U.S. Catholics to participate in global solidarity initiatives, from anything from praying, learning, acting, and giving. Those are kind of how we frame a lot of our programs. And since you mentioned that it's Advent, I think a great, you know, season of giving, we actually really embrace it's fair trade. And we have an online community called Ethical Trade at ethicaltrade.crs.org, and I have like a little magazine here.
Just to
pull it up just to show it. But essentially, this is a community of individuals that are committed to fairly traded items, and we really believe that improving your consumer patterns can really help and benefit people around the world that are living in very desperate situations. So what we do with CRS, we have a lot of companies that have aligned or similar values and a mission, and we will vet all of the companies that come to us and look at things like, you know, their environmental practices. We look at if they're really treating people with human dignity and offering fair wages, and several other categories. Those are just a few. And if we find that we're matched, then we will advertise some of their you know, fairly traded goods, coffee, teas, things like that in this online community where people can make purchases for things like church bazaars around the shopping season or, you know, sometimes even through things like bringing a vendor onto campus. That's like Equal Exchange is another one in Massachusetts. So those are a couple of examples. And then one other I'd like to just highlight today, too, is our work in advocacy, because that really is one of the, you know, part of the bread and butter of what we do. So we try to train members of the laity and church leaders, diocesan leaders, on some of the fundamentals of advocacy, you know, 101. Just how do you do it? Why is it important to us as Catholics? How can we take an active stance on important global issues? So we do that. That's another part of some of my job is social justice education and awareness raising.
You have a lot of parts of your job.
Yeah, it's
a lot
of fun.
Going on.
There's a lot to do.
I could tell that you really enjoy it. Why do you enjoy it so much?
I think it's exciting because I always say I'm a relationship manager. I get to meet people every single day. And at the heart and core of being Catholic is being in relationship with others. Mm-hmm. And I get to do that. And I get to talk about, and I've even been able to travel overseas with CRS, so I understand we really are benefiting and working for the most vulnerable brothers and sisters around the world, and making an impact on global poverty, which is critically important to me.
You know, we've all been energized and inspired by the Share the Journey campaign. Many bishops around the country have latched on to this call from Pope Francis. Mm-hmm. Can you share with us a little bit about that campaign and how that's going?
Absolutely. So Pope Francis on September 27th made a call to us globally at the Catholic Church. He says, we really need to take leadership on this issue of supporting refugees and immigrants around the world. There's been, and really he wants us to change the conversation and to move away from feelings of fear towards feelings of acceptance and tolerance and recognizing people's inherent human dignity as part of Catholic social teaching. So, you know, he really wants us to be, to embrace in the encounter with Christ through people and to live out the call of, like, the Good Samaritan, for example. So the first step, I would say, he's encouraging us to just understand and love our neighbor. So people in our own communities, to embrace them. And then beyond that is to really think in a bigger picture and to really petition our governments to support fairer policies around immigration and likewise to support, you know, agencies like CRS and others, similar agencies that are helping to support people that are displaced overseas. Mm-hmm. So when I think of the core and the heart of this campaign, I really think about, you know, the call to love our neighbor. And here in Boston, just a couple of weeks ago, Cardinal O'Malley said a mass to celebrate this Share the Journey campaign, and he invited parishioners in a parish in Lynn, Massachusetts. And so they actually invited resettled refugees to sit at the front of the mass of the church. And after mass, I spoke with a woman that had been resettled and just wanted to learn her story, because that's what Pope Francis told us to do. And she looked me squarely in the eye and she said, "I fled from Iraq during the war, and if I hadn't been resettled here, I wouldn't be alive today." Mm-hmm. And today she's giving back herself and she's welcoming refugees and helping people to readjust to life in the States.
Great story.
Yeah.
You guys do such great work. Where can people learn more about the work of Catholic Relief?
Absolutely. So if you want to learn about Share the Journey, you can go to sharejourney.org. And if you're interested in learning more about CRS broadly in the field, we have crs.org, or you can go onto our Facebook page, or you can follow us at Catholic Relief.
Well, Danielle, it's been a pleasure talking with you, a fellow Boston fan, and who does great work. Very much appreciated that you took the time to be with us today.
Thank you so much for having me.
We'll be back with more of This Is a Day right after this.